So one of the big things, one of the big challenges carp anglers face, and I had a problem with it, I struggled with it for a long time when I first started, is getting a good carp picture. It's very difficult to explain to someone how to take a good carp picture. You know, you fish with a couple buddies for a long time, and everybody pretty much knows the deal. They'll tell you to lift the head of the fish, put the tail down, whatever you got to do. Fishing by yourself, you don't have that option. And especially when you're handling a big fish and making sure you're taking care of it, it's extremely difficult to get a good picture. So the first thing I do when I start a session or I get to a new spot is I will set up my photo area. Most of the fish I catch don't even make it up here. If I can even avoid taking them out of the water, I do. Just kind of pop the hook off and release them as quickly as possible. I want to make sure when I get a big fish or a good fish that I get a good picture of it, regardless of the conditions, regardless if I'm by myself. I don't have to depend on someone else to, you know, a passerby take a picture of, you know, a 30-pound fish. I get home and it's missing a tail, it's missing its head. So, my setup is very simple. I run a piece of PVC pipe pounded into the ground. Got a monopod for my camera. That camera, the main reason I purchased it is because it's waterproof and it's got a custom timer on it. I set the custom timer for 10 seconds and 15 shots. And I mean, unless it's a super downpour, I know I can leave this camera out all night. It's always ready to go no matter what if I'm fishing, you know, if I've got lines in 24 hours a day. So once I get it set up and I'm pretty comfortable with where I'm at, I'll take a test picture. Just a simple, quick picture to make sure I'm good to go. So this one I'm just gonna set for 10 seconds. Give me enough time to get over there. And set up like you're holding the fish. I'll check my picture. And if I have to, I'll make adjustments, but for the most part, that is pretty much set for the day. And with 15 shots, I'll position the fish in different areas, different angles, so that way if I get two clips of 15 shots, so I get 30 pictures, I know for sure there's gonna be a couple good ones in there. Night pictures are a little more difficult, but I know at least with this setup that I'm gonna get the fish, I'm gonna get the picture I'm looking for, and I really don't have to sack a fish up if I don't want to, which I don't think I've ever done. So hopefully that helps you, gives you an idea of, you know, a couple little things you can do to make sure that you, when you're out there looking for marge, trying to catch a big carp, you have a good picture at the end of the day, and it's something you can look back on and smile.